One good day to the people of Tobago. It's certainly a joy to be with you again on Moment of Deliverance. Remember, I was with you last week, and I promise you that this week you would be getting part two of the message on same-sex relationship. I hope that the message you heard last, the part of the message that you heard last week really blessed your heart and enlightened you as to how God repudiates same-sex relationship. I want you to know that this second part of the message is very, very important as it seeks to bring a closure from God's word to that whole argument as to whether same-sex marriage is acceptable. At the end, it would be very clear in your minds and in your heart that God totally repudiates this kind of behavior among his creation. However, before we go to the message, I want to remind you of our services that are being held at the Calvary Road Deliverance Tabernacle, 9:30 a.m. on Sunday morning, and on Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. our Bible study. And on Friday nights, we have our deliverance services being held at 8 p.m. And I want to encourage you to come and experience your deliverance. You may be having demonic problems. You may be having all kinds of complications in your life. Your deliverance awaits you if you come to our deliverance service on Friday nights. Also at the Lowlands Lifeline or Branch Church, we have our services there on Sunday morning at 7:30 a.m. and on Tuesday, our Bible study at 7 p.m. and on Thursday at 7 p.m. prayer meeting. I trust that you will stand with many of us who totally disagree and support what God says in his word, that same-sex relationship is unacceptable. May God bless you as you listen to part two of this message.
Are you with me, brethren? Because you know what the homosexuals do? They go to the Bible to get support for their evil practice. And they try to say, amen, that when God condemned homosexuality, amen, in the Old Testament, it was under the Mosaic law, so it doesn't hold today. But they need to understand, amen, that God condemned what the heathens were doing. But you don't want to condemn homosexuality. But in the same passage, it condemns bestiality. It condemns incest. Are you with me? And so evil is this practice that God said something that is very important. Hear what God says. Let's read on in the same passage. Verse 25 says, and the land is defiled there. Therefore, I do visit the iniquity upon it. And the land itself vomited out the inhabitants. Ye shall therefore keep my statutes and my judgments, and shall not commit any of these abominations, neither any of your own nation, nor any stranger that sojourneth among you. For all these abominations have the men of the land done, which were before you. And the land is defiled, that the land spew not you out also, when you defile it, as it spewed out the nations that were before you. For whosoever shall commit any of these abominations, even the souls that commit them shall be cut off from among their people. That's how serious God was. How he repudiated, amen, homosexuality, bestiality, incest, and these things. God hated it. As a matter of fact, he says the land would reject you. I want you to observe the nations who have given credence to these things, what is happening to them, the kind of problems and perplexities that are developing. Watch what's happening to America. What's happening to our economy? What's happening to Europe? The land would begin to reject them. Nothing would go right. Mark my word, you would see the complexities and the perplexities that will take place in these nations. And if Trinidad and Tobago go likewise and accept same-sex relationship and same-sex marriage, we are going to have more problems than we already have. You think the murder rate is high, it's going to escalate, and all other complications will develop in our land. Amen. That our oil reserves are going to dwindle. The oil will disappear, and natural gas from under the earth, and we are going to be in trouble if we don't rather abhor the detestable practice of homosexuality, if we condone it, if we embrace it, if our government, amen, decide to accept this, it's going to bring the judgment of God upon us as it's coming on other nations. Whether we like it or not, God hates it. Paul, in his teachings, in his epistles, condemns homosexuality among the pagans. And Paul, I think there's no passage in the Bible that is as forceful and explicit as the Apostle Paul, as he writes to the Romans in chapter 1. Verse 24, hear what Paul says. Wherefore, let me read earlier up from verse 21. Because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their what? Imaginations. Their foolish heart was what? Darkened. Professing themselves to be wise, they became what? Fools. And changed the glory of the uncorruptible God into an image made like to what? Corruptible man, and to birds, and to four-footed beasts, and creeping things. Wherefore, God also what? Gave them up to what? Uncleanness, through the lust of their own hearts, to dishonor their own what? Bodies between themselves, who changed the truth of God into a lie. Come on, that is what they're trying to do. They're trying to change the what? Truth of God into a lie. What is the truth as it relates to what we are dealing with? The truth is, when God, amen, instituted marriage, he said that the marriage institution must be between a male and a female. But now the world wants to change that and say it's all right for a man and a man. Once they mutually consent, it's right for them to do it, or a woman and a woman. Hear me? That's a lie. God never intended, amen, that a man and a man should marry a woman and a woman. The Bible is very clear. They changed the truth of God into a lie, and worship and serve the creature more than the creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. For this cause, God gave them up unto what? Vile affections. For even their women did change the natural use into that which is against what? Nature. So you know what's going on here? What is the natural use? Women were going with women. That's against nature. Are you with me, brethren? And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with what? Men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was what? Meat. And even as they did not want to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not what? Convenient. Men with men, women with women. The natural use. Hear me, it's unnatural for a woman to go with a woman. It's unnatural for a man to go with a man. But it's natural for a male and a female to go together.
A pleasant good day to the people of Tobago. It's certainly a joy to be with you again on Moment of Deliverance. Remember, I was with you last week, and I promise you that this week you would be getting part two of the message on same-sex relationship. I hope that the message you heard last, the part of the message that you heard last week really blessed your heart and enlightened you as to how God repudiates same-sex relationship. I want you to know that this second part of the message is very, very important as it seeks to bring a closure from God's word to that whole argument as to whether same-sex marriage is acceptable. At the end, it would be very clear in your minds and in your heart that God totally repudiates this kind of behavior among his creation. However, before we go to the message, I want to remind you of our services that are being held at the Calvary Road Deliverance Tabernacle, 9:30 a.m. on Sunday morning, and on Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. our Bible study. And on Friday nights, we have our deliverance services being held at 8 p.m. And I want to encourage you to come and experience your deliverance. You may be having demonic problems. You may be having all kinds of complications in your life. Your deliverance awaits you if you come to our deliverance service on Friday nights. Also at the Lowlands Lifeline or Branch Church, we have our services there on Sunday morning at 7:30 a.m. and on Tuesday, Bible study at 7 p.m. and on Thursday at 7 p.m. prayer meeting. I trust that you will stand with many of us who totally disagree and support what God says in his word, that same-sex relationship is unacceptable. May God bless you as you listen to part two of this message.
Are you with me, brethren? Because you know what the homosexuals do? They go to the Bible to get support for their evil practice. And they try to say, amen, that when God condemned homosexuality, amen, in the Old Testament, it was under the Mosaic law, so it doesn't hold today. But they need to understand, amen, that God condemned what the heathens were doing. But you don't want to condemn homosexuality. But in the same passage, it condemns bestiality. It condemns incest. Are you with me? And so evil is this practice that God said something that is very important. Hear what God says. Let's read on in the same passage. Verse 25 says, and the land is defiled there, therefore I do visit the iniquity upon it, and the land itself vomiteth out the inhabitants. Ye shall therefore keep my statutes and my judgments, and shall not commit any of these abominations, neither any of your own nation, nor any stranger that sojourneth among you. For all these abominations have the men of the land done, which were before you, and the land is defiled, that the land spew not you out also when you defile it, as it spewed out the nations, that will be for you. For whosoever shall commit any of these abominations, even the souls that commit them shall be cut off from among their people. That's how serious God was. How he repudiated, amen, homosexuality, bestiality, incest, and these things. God hated it. As a matter of fact, he says the land would reject you. I want you to observe the nations who have given credence to these things, what is happening to them, the kind of problems and perplexities that are developing. What's what's happening to America? What's what's happening to her economy? What's what's happening to Europe? The land would begin to reject them. Nothing would go right. Mark my word, you would see the complexities and the perplexities that will take place in these nations. And if Trinidad and Tobago go likewise and accept same-sex relationship and same-sex marriage, we are going to have more problems than we already have. You think the murder rate is high? It's going to escalate, and all other complications will develop in our land. Amen. That our oil reserves are going to dwindle. The oil will disappear, and natural gas from under the earth, and we are going to be in trouble if we don't rather abhor the detestable practice of homosexuality, if we condone it, if we embrace it, if our government, amen, decide to accept this, it's going to bring the judgment of God upon us as it's coming on other nations. Whether we like it or not, God hates it. Paul, in his teachings, in his epistles, condemns homosexuality among the pagans. And Paul, I think there's no passage in the Bible that is as forceful and explicit as the Apostle Paul, as he writes to the Romans in chapter 1. Verse 24, hear what Paul says. Wherefore, let me read earlier up from verse 21. Because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their what? Imaginations. Their foolish heart was what? Darkened, professing themselves to be wise. They became what? Fools. And changed the glory of the uncorruptible God into an image made like to what? Corruptible man, and to birds, and to four-footed beasts, and creeping things. Wherefore, God also what? Gave them up to what? Uncleanness, through the lust of their own hearts, to dishonor their own what? Bodies between themselves, who changed the truth of God into a lie. Come on, that is what they're trying to do. They're trying to change the what truth of God into a lie. What is the truth as it relates to what we are dealing with? The truth is, when God, amen, instituted marriage, he said that the marriage institution must be between a male and a female. But now the world wants to change that and say it's all right for a man and a man. Once they mutually consent, it's right for them to do it, or a woman and a woman. Hear me? That's a lie. God never intended, amen, that a man and a man should marry a woman and a woman. The Bible is very clear. They changed the truth of God into a lie, and worship and serve the creature more than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. For this cause, God gave them up unto what? Vile affections. For even their women did change the natural use into that which is against what? Nature. So you know what's going on here? What is the natural use? Women were going with women. That's against nature. Are you with me, brethren? And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with what? Men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was what? Meat. And even as they did not want to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not what? Convenient. Men with men, women with women. The natural use. Hear me, it's unnatural for a woman to go with a woman. It's unnatural for a man to go with a man. But it's natural for a male and a female to go together.
A pleasant good day to the people of Tobago. It's certainly a joy to be with you again on Moments of Deliverance. Remember, I was with you last week, and I promise you that this week you would be getting part two of the message on same-sex relationship. I hope that the message you heard last, the part of the message that you heard last week really blessed your heart and enlightened you as to how God repudiates same-sex relationship. I want you to know that this second part of the message is very, very important as it seeks to bring a closure from God's word to that whole argument as to whether same-sex marriage is acceptable. At the end, it would be very clear in your minds and in your heart that God totally repudiates this kind of behavior among his creation. However, before we go to the message, I want to remind you of our services that are being held at the Calvary Road Deliverance Tabernacle, 9:30 a.m. on Sunday morning, and on Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. our Bible study. And on Friday nights, we have our deliverance services being held at 8 p.m. And I want to encourage you to come and experience your deliverance. You may be having demonic problems. You may be having all kinds of complications in your life. Your deliverance awaits you if you come to our deliverance service on Friday nights. Also at the Lowlands Lifeline or Branch Church, we have our services there on Sunday morning at 7:30 a.m. and on Tuesday, our Bible study at 7 p.m. and on Thursday at 7 p.m. prayer meeting. I trust that you will stand with many of us who totally disagree and support what God says in his word, that same-sex relationship is unacceptable. May God bless you as you listen to part two of this message.
Are you with me, brethren? Because you know what the homosexuals do? They go to the Bible to get support for their evil practice. And they try to say, amen, that when God condemned homosexuality, amen, in the Old Testament, it was under the Mosaic law, so it doesn't hold today. But they need to understand, amen, that God condemned what the heathens were doing. But you don't want to condemn homosexuality. But in the same passage, it condemns bestiality. It condemns incest. Are you with me? And so evil is this practice that God said something that is very important. Hear what God says. Let's read on in the same passage. Verse 25 says, "And the land is defiled there. Therefore, I do visit the iniquity upon it, and the land itself vomiteth out the inhabitants. Ye shall therefore keep my statutes and my judgments, and shall not commit any of these abominations, neither any of your own nation, nor any stranger that sojourneth among you. For all these abominations have the men of the land done, which were before you, and the land is defiled, that the land spew not you out also, when you defile it, as it spewed out the nations that were before you. For whosoever shall commit any of these abominations, even the souls that commit them shall be cut off from among their people." That's how serious God was. How he repudiated, amen, homosexuality, bestiality, incest, and these things. God hated it. As a matter of fact, he says the land will reject you. I want you to observe the nations who have given credence to these things, what is happening to them, the kind of problems and perplexities that are developing. Watch what's happening to America. Watch what's happening to her economy. Watch what's happening to Europe. The land would begin to reject them. Nothing would go right. Mark my word, you would see the complexities and the perplexities that will take place in these nations. And if Trinidad and Tobago go likewise and accept same-sex relationship and same-sex marriage, we are going to have more problems than we already have. You think the murder rate is high? It's going to escalate, and all other complications will develop in our land. Amen. That our oil reserves are going to dwindle. The oil will disappear, and natural gas from under the earth, and we are going to be in trouble if we don't rather abhor the detestable practice of homosexuality, if we condone it, if we embrace it, if our government, amen, decide to accept this, it's going to bring the judgment of God upon us as it's coming on other nations. Whether we like it or not, God hates it. Paul, in his teachings, in his epistles, condemns homosexuality among the pagans. And Paul, I think there's no passage in the Bible that is as forceful and explicit as the Apostle Paul, as he writes to the Romans in chapter 1. Verse 24, hear what Paul says. Wherefore, let me read earlier up from verse 21. "Because that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their what? Imaginations. Their foolish heart was what? Darkened. Professing themselves to be wise, they became what? Fools. And changed the glory of the uncorruptible God into an image made like to what? Corruptible man, and to birds, and to four-footed beasts, and creeping things. Wherefore, God also what? Gave them up to what? Uncleanness, through the lust of their own hearts, to dishonor their own what? Bodies between themselves, who changed the truth of God into a lie." Come on, that is what they're trying to do. They're trying to change the what truth of God into a lie. What is the truth as it relates to what we are dealing with? The truth is, when God, amen, instituted marriage, he said that the marriage institution must be between a male and a female. But now the world wants to change that and say it's all right for a man and a man. Once they mutually consent, it's right for them to do it, or a woman and a woman. Hear me? That's a lie. God never intended, amen, that a man and a man should marry a woman and a woman. The Bible is very clear. They changed the truth of God into a lie and worship and serve the creature more than the creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. For this cause, God gave them up unto what? Vile affections. For even their woman did change the natural use into that which is against what? Nature. So you know what's going on here? What is the natural use? Women were going with women. That's against nature. Are you with me, brethren? And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with what? Men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was what? Meat.